Found off my big home. The bees are buzzing in the tree to make some honey just for me. When you look under the rocks and plants and take a glance at the fancy ants, then maybe you can try it for you.
Is it? Aren't you scaring the animals or doing like that to Lucy today?
I like the white one.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Are you going shopping? What are they?
There's a tree line.
Oh my gosh, look!
What did you hear, Donna?
Wow, look, guys.
Mine. No, you're rubbish.
Your hands off the
glass. It's a place for motion.
it's in here, look. There's any other stuff in there.
It's you.
What else happened?
That mumbo.
Oh look, there you go.
Now, hippos are vegetarians, and it looks like it is dinner time for them. They are busy eating.
Wow, look.
And it takes quite a bit of veggies for them to get up to their full size. They tip the scales about 5,500 pounds when they're full grown like this. Wow. They will spend most of their time in the water like this. They can actually stay submerged up to 8 minutes at a time. But being the size that they are, it can sometimes make it difficult to swim, so instead they'll usually move through the water by walking or running along the bottom of the pool they're in at the time. They look pretty docile right now, but they are one of Africa's most dangerous animals. They are very territorial. It's a good thing that we are keeping our distance. We are in luck, my friends! It is a baby hippo out of the water on our left!
The baby bunny, can you see him?
That baby is already very large. As you can see, they're born weighing 50 to 100 pounds already. And because of all the time that hippos spend in the water, that baby can nurse submerged. Once it goes under the water, its eyes, ears, and nostrils automatically close. Now at the bottom of this hill here, you'll see a couple of Ankole cattle with those giant horns. Those horns might look super heavy on top of their head, but they're mostly hollow. The inside looks really similar to a honeycomb pattern. They're essentially a built-in cooling system for these cows. Throughout the day, they'll push blood in front of those horns, disperse some extra heat, and that blood will come back down into their bodies a little cooler. And you'll hear them mooing as well. Just like the cattle we're familiar with, except theirs are quite a bit louder than what we're used to. Looks like there is a den over on our left. We'll peek inside, see if anybody is home right now. So it looks like there are a couple of hyenas curled up in there. Hyenas look very dog-like, but they are not members of the canine family. They are members of their own family, the Hyenidae. While they have a bad rap as scavengers, they do hunt for the majority of their own food. A large group of giraffes together like this has a fun animal group name. They're called a tower. Very fitting. Then see if you can't catch a glimpse of that long giraffe tongue. That tongue is 18 inches long. That's from the tips of our fingers down to our elbow. Can even lick their own eyeballs.
Wow.
Oh, no.
And their tongues are also a bluish black color to prevent them from getting sunburnt since they're out so much during the day. These giraffes out here are Maasai giraffes. You can tell they have a bit more jagged pattern than other species of giraffes do. Each giraffe will have its own unique markings, similar to a human with their own unique fingerprint.
Oh, there is. Hose and hose.
Yeah.
Wow, look.
These cattle are very vocal up here today.
Oh,
up on that hill there. Water bugs get their name from their love of aquatic environments. And it's a good thing those water bugs are some distance from us. They secrete a greasy oil, which essentially waterproofs their fur, but it smells very, very bad. Now, these guys are very brave. There are a couple of cheetahs moving around up there. One very close to those rocks, and one a little bit over to the right there. The cheetahs are the fastest land animal in the world. They can go from 0 to 60 miles an hour in just under 3 seconds, and they can run upwards of 70 miles an hour.
Wow.
And unlike many other big cats, they'll do most of their hunting during the day. They have a couple of black marks beneath each eye, and that helps to reflect the sun so they can better see their prey.
Notice that tails look very different. Because our female, when she came in, she had a luxated tailbone. So her tail is fine now, but it just kind of sits at a very different angle than normal, and which causes her to kind of gator on her own feathers. So this is a good look to make sure that they are they're clean. And then we're going to feed the boy, and what he's gonna do, he's gonna vocalize, he's gonna display, and he's actually gonna hopefully feed our beef.
Why did he not feed the bird?
No, he shook his head no.
Oh!
That's really cool. So, we know that's one of the first signs that they're going to kick off breeding season. When they do behaviors like that. So.
That is amazing.
Let's do it again here.
I'm gonna go get